Shane Street song.
Yeah.
Come on now. Yeah. Hallelujah. Let's do this in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Some of you never heard it. Some of you going to hear it for the first time. Has anybody ever heard about Shane Street? Okay, now this song was played. This is a song. I'll just tell it like it is. There was a dude in the suburbs watching television with his comfortable screen TV in the remote, and God started talking to him to come down to the hood. This is his story. Turn it up.
Turn it up.
He didn't want to hear God's voice.
Down on Shane Street.
shake.
So a little later on, we're just going to pray for people that want prayer. We're going to pray that God would bless people, that He would fill them, that He would show them their purpose in life. Amen. God's called you to walk tall in His kingdom.
Amen.
God's called you to throw your shoulders back, hold your head up high, amen, and walk like you're the child of the Most High King, amen. We are sons and daughters of the Most High. That's a reason to walk up straight. See, here's how the devil wants us to walk around. The devil wants us to walk around with our head hanging low and dragging our tail on the ground. Amen. The devil wants us to live in shame. See, that's Satan's plan. He's your enemy. He came to steal and kill and to destroy. But Jesus said in the rest of that verse that I've come that they would have life and life more abundantly. How many of you are ready for a fresh dose of life today? Amen. I always need another dose of life.
Amen.
God's moving in this city. God's moving in this city. G-O-D in the 313.
Come on.
Say it with me. G-O-D in the 313. One more time. G-O-D in the 313. Amen. God is here. He's brought you to this special place today. You have an appointment with God today, so we're just going to relax here today.
Hallelujah.
We're going to have a good time. We're going to enter into God's presence. We're going to focus on Him. We're going to have some good food later. But before we get into the physical food, we're just going to take in some more spiritual food. Amen. This young man's going to minister to us for a little while. What was your name again, sister?
Sister Ruthie.
Sister Ruthie there. Raise your hand, Ruthie. She's going to sing us some songs.
What's up?
Just gonna have a great time in the Lord. That's all there is to it.
Amen. That's
right.
Right,
Joe,
right, Terry?
Right.
You got
Joe,
it. Amen. Jesus Christ. I'm glad you're saved, brother.
G-O-D and the 313.
Amen. That's right. So, Father, we thank you. Lord, I just pray for your special blessing upon people here today. I just pray, Lord, for your encouragement to hit people today, that you would just give people that hope. In the name of Jesus, that you just fill people with new dreams and goals and passions in life. And Father, just draw us to yourself and just show every single person in here how much you love them.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, hallelujah.
So we're just going to let Ben take it away here as soon as he's ready.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. All right.
Trusting, trusting my truth.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yeah, you gonna come play me free bird, are you?
Oh, can I really do that? It was a joke. Probably.
All right. I'm not used to playing this early anymore. So, gotta take a second and get used to the sound up here.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Welcome to Peacemakers. Welcome to Peacemakers.
Well, Christmas time is coming. So I've got a little, start us off with a little jazzy version of Silent Night.
Good to see my brother, praise God.
All right.
Able to live anew. That is what the Lord.
Hey, Dick. How'd you get here? You walk. All the way from your place. You really believe that?
He was.
He walked from 6 Mile Woodward to Shane.
Yep.
Hey, cowboy, what's up?
I'm blessed.
Man, I've been worried about you.
Yeah, I finally got here.
Man, we miss you.
Yeah, my daughter had surgery.
What's that, Miss Shirley?
Better than I was yesterday.
Good. Hey, where you been, man?
I'm blessed. I'm still coming. I got a church on 9 Mile. I'm going to give y'all a donation. I got to get that address back. I lost the address.
We miss you, brother.
Thank you.
I was worried about you.
Thank you. Praise God.
Praise God. You're back.
Hold fast to your first love. Keep your faith in God. Now tell me who's that riding? John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding? John the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding? John the Revelator wrote the
part
of the seven disciples, and three he led away. He said, watch with me 1 hour while I go yawn and pray. Now tell me who's that riding? Shown the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding? Shown the Revelator. Tell me who's that riding? Wrote the book of the seven seals.
Can I really do that? It was a joke.
All right. I'm not used to playing this early anymore. So, gotta take a second, get used to the sound up here. Well, Christmas time's coming, so I've got a little, start us off with a little jazzy version of Silent Night.
With God and the world. the blind, able to see, able to live anew. That is what the Lord will do for you. Thank you. Everybody's talking about the gospel. Wrote the book of the seven seals.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, right.
Trying to get used to the sound up here. No warm up, no nothing. So take it as it comes. If my heart is overwhelmed and I cannot hear your voice, I'll hold on to what is true, though I cannot see. When the storms of life, they come, and the road ahead gets steep, I will lift my hands in faith, I will believe. Remind myself of all that you've done. In the life I have because of your son. Oh, love came down and rescued me. Love came down and set me free. When my heart is filled with hope and every promise comes my way, when I feel your hand of grace rest upon me, staying desperate for you, God, staying humble at your feet, I will lift my hands in praise. I do believe. I remind myself of all that you've done. In the life I have because of Jesus. Mountain. kind of working on this little vocal record I've been doing called Dark But Lovely. And the main song off the record, is out of Song of Solomon 1:5, which says, I am dark but lovely. The sun has tanned me. The trials of this life have scarred me. But to you, I'm lovely. And Psalm 139, where it talks about the Lord never leaves us, no matter where we go, no matter what we do, he will never leave us.
Good.
next song, I want to encourage everyone to be thinking about where you're at with God at this time of your life. After this next song he plays, I'm going to get back up here and we're going to talk a little bit more about that. And we're going to help people make that connection back with God. Everybody that needs it. So I want everyone to start thinking about that. Very important stuff.
Oh.
Ben, if you could just provide a background tune for us here. We're just gonna talk a little bit. Not for long at all, because I hear this food is ready for us in the kitchen, amen. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for some lunch. Amen. All the souls in heaven, what is it? All the angels in heaven rejoice when there's a soul saved. There is nothing that gives our Father God greater pleasure than when one of his lost sheep comes home. There is a story in the Bible, most of us, I'll bet, know this story. It's called The Prodigal Son. How many of us have ever heard this story before, The Prodigal Son? Well, in the story of the prodigal son, there was a father, and he had two sons, right? And one of the sons went to the father, and he said, "Father, I want my inheritance now. I want to go out and meet the world and sow my wild oats now. Give me what I have coming to me now." So this son went and took his father's inheritance. But he got out there in the world and he spent the inheritance and he started living wild and he started to let go to waste everything that his father had given him. He started letting go to waste all the good things that the father had set into his lap. And the son ultimately found himself in a pig pen. He had burnt all of his bridges. Amen. He had burnt all of his bridges. He lost everything because he was living too wild. He was living beyond his means, and he found himself in a pig pen. I don't know about you, but I found myself in one or two pig pens before. Is there anybody out there that can identify with that? Anthony, you look like you can identify with that. Leroy looks like he knows what I'm talking about. We go out there, and we've all done it. We waste what the Father's given us, and we crash and burn out there. It is a ruthless, evil world out there. This world out there, amen, the parts of it that the devil has taken control of, it'll chew us up and spit us out, ultimately, when we try to play the devil's game. But you see, like Jesus says in John 10:10, Jesus said that the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But there's good news attached to that. Jesus said, "I came that they would have life and have it more abundantly." Jesus provided a remedy. He provided a solution to these problems out here that we've all found ourselves in. So as the story goes, the prodigal son, the kid found himself out there in the pig pen, eating the food of the pigs. He had nowhere to go. He had reached the bottom of the barrel. He couldn't fall any farther. And then the Bible says that he came to himself. And he started thinking a little more clearly. And he's like, "You know what? Jeez. When I was at my father's house, I may have not always liked his rules and all that, but man, I had it better then than I do now." And he kept thinking, you know, and he kept thinking, and finally he had the bright idea. He's like, "You know what, man, I really hate to go back to my father and admit that I failed. I really hate to admit that I couldn't do it on my own." He's like, "But you know what? This situation's brought me to my knees. I'm going to go back to the Father. I'm going to go back home where I belong, to where my Father loves me. Amen. I'm going to go back to where I know there is love. God has an unconditional love for us. All these human beings out here, there's only so much that we can do for each other. Because all of us at our core, we're selfish. You know, we want things our way. You know, we like to have things accommodate to us. And quiet as kept, Anthony, I don't like it when you inconvenience me too much. See, that's human love at its best. But you see, Father God has a love, amen? He has a love that is unconditional. And that there are no limits. And God ain't looking around asking what's in it for me. The Bible says God so loved that he gave.
Well,
God gave to us. That's love. That's sacrificial love. And God is reaching out to all of us right now, giving. He is trying to give. Have you ever tried to give somebody a gift, but they didn't want to take it? How many have ever had that happen? Put your hands up. See, sometimes you can have the best gift in the world. And sometimes you might know exactly what a person needs. And you can try to give it because you're trying to help them. But see, they still got to receive it. They have to accept the gift. If they don't put their hands out and accept the gift that you're trying to give them, they ain't going to get it. And see, God loved us so much. Amen. And he loves us so much today, 2013, that he extends a special present to all of us today. Amen. It's a present of love. It's a gift from God. It's a perfect gift of love. And it's his son, Jesus. Amen. And in John 3:16 it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall what? Shall not perish, but have everlasting life." God has a destiny for us, and it is called everlasting life. God don't like seeing us in the pig pen. See, we get real hard-headed. Some of us, I've been there, we like to hit our head up against this wall. We like to have a contest. Who can do it the most? See, God don't like to see us in the pig pen, man. That's why he sent his son to redeem us out of all this mess. To redeem us from ourselves, Cleo. Because you see, Cleo, you can be your own worst enemy. I can trip myself up when things are going good. Amen. I can cause my own failures. Because the Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We've all fallen short. Ain't none of us perfect. Look, just because I'm a leader in a church and all this type of stuff, it doesn't mean I'm perfect. It doesn't mean that I don't have flaws. So it shows me that I need Jesus. I need Jesus just like Ben needs Jesus. I need Jesus just like Cleo needs Jesus. Because see, ultimately, we are all in the same boat. We're all in on this together. Ain't none of us better than the other. We all desperately need a Savior, and without him, we're all screwed, Cleo. Every one of us. Doesn't matter what side of the tracks you were born on. Doesn't matter what city you live in. Doesn't matter what church you go to. Without Jesus, we are all lost. And what I want to do right now is I want to give people an opportunity to meet Jesus. There's no reason that anyone has to walk out that door without getting in touch with God here today. You can walk out that door and know that you have eternal life. Whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And when you study out that word believe in the Bible, it means opening up your real heart to Jesus. It means clinging to Jesus, trusting in him, relying on him. This is the key to life, folks. and it is the way that we get our sins forgiven. I want to encourage people to come on up here right now. Come on up here right now if you want to dedicate your life to Jesus. Come on up here, even if you've done it before and you feel like you've fallen off the track and you need a fresh touch with God, come on up here. Come on up here if you're not sure if you have eternal life. Come on up here if you're not sure where you stand with God. It's always hardest being the first person to come. It takes someone brave to be an icebreaker. Who's breaking the ice here today? Praise God. We got some females leading the pack here. We got some females that are being God's champions. They're being the icebreakers. They're leading the pack today. God bless you. Do you guys have any idea how much God loves you? He really does. He loves you enough to brought you to this crazy place. These crazy people on Shane Street. See, God wants to give you hope. He's got a plan for your life.
Yes, Lord, yes.
God's going to fill you with hope.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. I've been hopeless before. Come on. Anyone else? I know there's somebody else out there. This is a classic time to just get in touch with God. We ain't going to take up an offering. We ain't going to ask you for money. We're just looking to feed people. I'll go home and get a good night's sleep tonight. Hey, who wants to receive the love of the Father? I know that there's just got to be another person that's twitching in their seat. Yeah, don't feel shy. Don't be bashful. Just come on up. You know, it's all good. Because I want to pray with you. We want to receive what God has to give us. We don't want to turn away gifts from God anymore.
My problem is that I went to Old Chapel and they wouldn't let me sing, like, because God would tell me to do things and I don't like it.
You wanted to sing?
Yeah, right now we just want to hear and sing.
Well, is it okay if we have her sing a song in a few minutes? Amen. God's given you a gift. He wants to hear your voice. Come on now. Who wants to make sure that they're receiving the love of the Father? Letitia. Is there anyone else? Because I'm going to wind us down. We're going to be eating very soon. Anyone else that wants to receive the gift of eternal life that God is extending to us today? Amen. Okay, we're going to pray for these three young ladies here. And I'm going to ask everyone else in the room to just pray for them as I'm leading them in this prayer. I'm going to lead them to Christ. I'm going to show them exactly what to say. It's going to be real simple. Tyrone, you're an up-and-coming preacher, prayer warrior. Why don't you come on up here, man? Come on up here and help me pray over these people. Amen. God wants to use you. Amen.
Amen.
Don't you think God has a plan for their life?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
You really believe that? I can tell.
I do. I believe you.
Amen. God has good things in store for them, right?
Yep. Amen.
Amen. Well, I want you to you go behind them and lay hands on them on their help me pray with them. Yeah, just put. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, lady, actually, go ahead behind them, Tyrone, so they can see me a little better. Yeah, just lay hands on their backs. We're going to pray for them. Okay, ladies, here's what we need.